Hi, David Ray with Scubapro and Alan Williams with Ray's Diving, Scubapro dealer. We developed the S-Tek backplate and wing for the advanced technical diver, but we also made it versatile enough to work really well with the recreational diver and single tank diver. My years of experience with technical diving, cave exploration, expeditions, and teaching cave diving allowed me to be able to work very closely with Scubapro in the development of these products. These products are going to allow us to take not only our expertise in technical diving, but the many years of innovation and manufacturing expertise that Scubapro has to make the best technical diving system in the industry. So when we started working on the S-Tek project, we decided we wanted to make a complete move away from the traditional style. Alan's holding the traditional style backplate that you can see has what we call has a break in it, where you create a channel in the middle of the backplate. This was our S-Tek plate, and it's been broken in a press that's going to bend the metal. So we stepped out of the box and decided to do a 3D formed process to where we make a mold and we actually stick the stainless steel in the mold, and then we use a many hundred ton press to press and actually form the stainless steel, taking on the shape of the diver's back and making the ultimate relationship with the back plate as far as comfort to the back, as well as not having to create the channel. Additionally, we built a handle into the unit for single tank diving. Of course, you wouldn't be able to pick your doubles up like this. You wouldn't want to, but this is designed for single tank divers to have the ability to be able to lift their entire system when it's completely rigged and move it in and out of the car, on and off the dive boats, things of this nature. Also, we went and pressed the areas for the wing nuts. As you know, the wing nuts normally come through the bolts, or the bolts come through the plate, and then you put on a wing nut. So what we did was created a socket that would allow you to submerge the what we call our Ergo-Nuts inside of this, keeping it flush to where it's not touching your back, damaging your suit, or filling it in any way. And at the same time, you can see it's simply pressed into the stainless steel when we make the back plate. Very simple design. So the Ergo nut is super cool. It's designed to do a couple of things. Number one, it's designed to give you a bigger surface area. So when you're out diving in cold water, like we're at today in the quarry, and your fingers are all soft and you're needing to assemble or disassemble your kit, you have a much bigger surface area versus just the wing nut itself that you're turning. Plus, of course, this being metal, it's going to be really cold on your fingers and stuff like that. Additionally, because we've put an O-ring on the back, and because of this surface area, you have more friction that you can get, so you're actually able to tighten it down tighter. The greatest part about the whole system is the Ergo nut is an advantage for you. It's a great additional benefit, but if you lose it, you break it, you drop it down in a crack on the dock you're walking out on, doesn't matter. As long as you have the wing nut, then you can still put the configuration together. So you've got a little trap door on each side. Simply take a small screwdriver and you can pop this open. It just opens up a little hatch. Then you take your standard wing nut. If you're using a metric wing nut for metric bolts or an imperial wing nut, doesn't matter which size you're using, whatever you use on your doubles will fit in here. So you put it inside, drop the cap back on. She's going to snap into place, and now you've captured your wing nut inside your Ergo nut. You have all the strength and the corrosion resistance of the stainless steel wing nut, but now I have an O-ring for friction to go into the sockets that we've punched into the S-Tek backplate, a large surface area for my cold fingers to be able to tighten, and because it's bigger, I can get a much better lockdown of my back plate to my doubles. You also notice that we've electro-polished this, making it very beautiful, and also this makes it more impervious to rusting. We removed a lot of holes from the previous plate and focused on holes that were very specific for the rest of the S-Tek equipment that we've created. We have a very nice back pad that you'll see in other videos that allows you to have a nice color pad for having your favorite color, as well as giving a little bit more comfort if you were to be diving with the system with just a rash guard or something like that. It also works as a storage pouch to be able to put an SMB or a life raft or anything you might want to put up there for emergency devices. When we made this plate, we used a CNC mill to actually polish each hole, all the radiuses, and all the slots that the webbing goes through, making this extremely soft and comfortable and not any kind of burrs or any rough areas. This allowed us to not only have a plate that is extremely comfortable and has no sharp edges, but it allows us to go to a lighter webbing, a softer webbing, because now all of the slots, having been milled with the CNC, are super clean, allowing a softer webbing without any possibility of cutting the webbing. This is a kind of a common thing with back plates, is with the weight of the cylinder, especially with the weight of double tanks when you're climbing a ladder, boat ladder getting back on, or you're walking in and out of a dive site, you have all that weight on your back, and that puts a lot of pressure on these harnesses. And if these aren't really smooth, it can start to cut the webbing. So we're able to use a real soft webbing, very, very comfortable, and at the same time have this all polished so everything's good and clean and won't harm that webbing. We have the PureTech system, which is one continuous piece of webbing. You can see there's a grommet hole here. Then we come through the right shoulder, down through the waist, and we have the other side comes through the left shoulder, down through the waist, but it's all one continuous piece of webbing. This is a Hogarthian style, and that's why we call it pure or clean or Hogarthian. That means that it's designed to be very, very reliable, but very simplistic. And part of that simplicity is having super strength. There's nothing really to break with this webbing. And then we have five D-rings. We have one on each shoulder, one on the left hip for the pressure gauge, one on the front of the crotch strap, and one on the back of the crotch strap. So the front crotch strap D-ring is designed for towing a diver when he's riding a scooter. So you clip the scooter to you and it pulls you through the water. The back one is for being able to carry extra reels or spare scooters if you're towing a scooter, in case you're doing a long exploration dive and you need multiple devices. The top right D-ring is used to clip off your long hose, backup lights, things that you can see in the configuration here. Backup light, pressure gauge on the left hip, your long hose when not being breathed, and of course, as we said, the D-rings for the crotch. The right or left D-ring here, excuse me, is for your other backup light, and then when we get into stage bottles, they're generally worn on the left, and that's how we hook those, is at the left chest D-ring and at the left hip D-ring. So your pure system has very specific design, and later in another video we're going to show you how to adjust this back plate to fit the diver and be able to utilize all the proper placement for these D-rings once the back plate is configured on the diver.